Indian economy grew from $193.491 billion in 1981 to $2.652 trillion in 2017. Look closely. This growth was riding on material use of 1.93 billion tons to 7.42 billion tons in the same period. Economic growth has to be decoupled from increasing material use, as natural resources are finite. What happens when all resources are over? Even before the resources are over, a dwindling supply of resources is bound to create price shock and economic instability. Uncontrolled extraction has also hidden cost of ecology and social conflicts. We have a predominantly linear economy with open ends. Extraction of resources, processing them, manufacturing, consumption. And at every stage, we keep on disposing of material that we think is of no use. We call it waste, and the waste is mounting. India's annual waste generation is rapidly increasing. This waste takes up a huge amount of land, pollutes soil, water bodies, groundwater, and contributes to climate change. What we are doing is depleting our natural resources and creating a mountain of harmful waste. Resource efficiency can solve these two problems at every stage of our economic activities. India's productivity of $357 per ton of material is lower than world average of $879. We need to get more out of less. In 2019, Niti Aayog, India's premier policy think tank, along with EU delegation in India, formed a national strategy on resource efficiency to catch up with efficient use of raw material. The draft policy on resource efficiency by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is driven by 6R: reduce, reuse, refurbish, redesign, remanufacture and recycle. Rethink waste as secondary raw material. This will reduce constant extraction of new resources. For instance, only from discarded automobiles we could recover 1.5 million tons of steel scrap, 1,80,000 tons of aluminium, 75,000 tons each of reusable plastics and rubber on an annual basis through closed-loop recycling. There is more. Resource efficiency has been planned to transform India into a circular economy. Circular economy closes all the gaps we find in a linear economy. We need to bend innumerable lines of production, turn all open tails to touch various mouths. That's circular economy without any leak. But circular economy is more than only waste management. It is a new way of thinking. Circular thinking. The big thing is to rethink product design. We should make products that last longer. They should be repairable and upgradable. European Parliament has already abolished planned obsolescence. That's the way to go. We can also share one product among many. Lease products instead of individually buying and owning everything. No more use and throw. In fact, it is a big part of Indian culture we need to revisit. Reinvent our economy. Remember 6R: reduce, reuse, refurbish, redesign, remanufacture and recycle. Let us turn an inefficient line into a clean and self-sustaining circle. A circular economy will help restore and regenerate the natural system. Shall we put a price to that?